you talk a lot, not just in the book, but also on your podcast about the elections in November. How much confidence do you think the American people can have in a fair election right now? And I do think, you know, sometimes when you talk about it, it's a little dangerous because obviously the Trump administration, based on the outcome, will also speak to the idea that it was not fair. So how do you frame it so that it just doesn't become a thing that everyone can sort of use for their own best interests?
Yeah, I mean, everyone is going to claim that it's rigged. That was a little trick they pulled in 2016 by, you know, Trump constantly saying it was rigged. It forced the Democrats into this position where they're like, it can't be rigged. And then when it was in some respects rigged, they had nothing to say. What they should be doing is pushing for election transparency and integrity early. They should be pushing for vote by mail because of the coronavirus, because of the dangers we are being put in by having physical voting. I've been worried about the integrity of this election for a long time before the virus came around. I've been worried about domestic voter suppression, foreign interference, insecure machines, and Trump simply refusing to leave. My new worry is that perhaps the election will be delayed or kind of indefinitely postponed. Usually, even autocrats love elections. You know, they like to have a fake election so that they could brag about the people's love. And I didn't think that Trump would turn down an opportunity to do that. But given this unprecedented public health crisis, it's uncertain what direction they'll go.
Don't take this the wrong way. There is a core pessimism to a lot of what you write about. But do you feel as though there might be a chance to come through this on the other side with a changed perspective from the American people? And where do you find optimism?
Yeah, I mean, I don't think about it so much in terms of optimism or pessimism or hope or hopelessness. I just try to do the right thing. You know, when you have so much chaos, when you have so much instability, you really have to look at your morals and your principles and how you treat people and the kind of life that you want to lead. And so I just try to do the right thing. I do try to make suggestions that are helpful in that respect. But I'm not going to have blind faith in eroding institutions that we've already seen fail. You know, what Americans, I think, have recognized by now, that institutions are only as good as the people who are willing to uphold them. And sometimes they have to uphold those institutions in the face of profound and unprecedented threats. And so far, that has not really happened. That doesn't mean it's too late. It doesn't mean that we're doomed. It does mean we're in for a rough ride and that we really have to get our bearings and focus always on telling the truth and treating people right.
Thank you so much, Sarah, for making time for us again. Obviously, I wish this would be in the studio, and hopefully next time it'll be in person. Please check out Sarah's new book, Hiding in Plain Sight. We got a couple copies for you, and we'll be right back with more Late Night. Thanks, Sarah.